In this video, we will compare an $8 kitchen knife versus a $250 knife. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the comparison, I want to go over some disclosures. The knives in this video are for reference only. I'm not getting paid to make this video or to include their knife in a video. No one will get a chance to preview my footage or thoughts before the video goes up on YouTube. If this video provided any value, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. Now, with the disclosures away, let's start with the comparison. While the $8 Kiwi knife shares some similarities with the $250 knife, the differences are directly noticeable. We will be looking at why the cooks love the $8 and the $250 knife. There's no doubt that the far more expensive knife will be better with the fit, finish and quality of materials. The Kiwi knife is and feels cheap and is made from inferior materials. You get what you paid for, but why do some cooks love the Kiwi knife so much? The most significant difference is the edge retention, and the Kiwi knives have a very soft stainless steel. They are very soft, which means that you most likely need to hone the knife after a few minutes of slicing. Compared to the $250 Japanese knife with a Rockwell of 63, which can easily hold the edge for a few months. The $250 knife can get a lot sharper. But the most important thing is that it can hold the sharpness for a significantly longer time. As for the $8 knife, you don't want to spend the extra time to make the knife as sharp as possible, since the benefits of the sharpness are pretty much gone after a few minutes of use. With that being said, the cheaper $8 Kiwi knife is so soft that you don't even need a whetstone to get the sharpness back. All you need is a honing rod, and you can maintain the knife with just a honing rod. As for the $250 knife, you eventually need to use a whetstone to maintain or recreate the knife edge. With the $8 knife, you don't have to worry about chipping the blade. It will simply bend. As with the $250 knife, you need to be a lot more careful since the edge retention and sharpness comes with a risk of chipping due to improper use. There are multiple knives with multiple price ranges. You as a consumer have a choice in deciding what blade will suit you the best. There are thousands of knives with different edge retention styles and for various purposes. You have to ask yourself if the longer edge retention is worth it for you or not. With the obsession with Japanese knives, people tend to go for a higher Rockwell hardness, which gives you longer edge retention. But with everything good comes a downside, and that is the edge durability. The higher you go, the more brittle the edge becomes. Knowing what works the best for you is more important than buying a popular knife that gets recommended. I understand why so many people love the $8 Kiwi knife. It shares many similarities with the $250 knife because it is thin, light, pretty much maintenance-free and worry-free for an affordable price despite the underwhelming edge retention. The $250 knife has a steep price point for several reasons. A knife artisan makes it with a limited workforce and supply. In return, you get a unique blade that is made with quality materials. Lucky for us, we can choose a knife based on our preference and price point from various brands. Is the $8 or $250 knife worth it or not? That is something only you can decide. There is no such thing as the best knife. A knife that works for a sushi chef will not work for your local butcher. The same applies to home cooks. The best knife, in your opinion, may not be the best for others. Therefore, it is essential to know what you plan to cook and what your preferred cutting style is. The goal is to find a suitable blade, material, and knife style to assist you in your daily cooking task as much as possible. To do that, you have to search what knife style suits you the best and what blade can withstand the job you put the knife on. A super sharp and extremely thin Japanese knife with a high Rockwell hardness will work excellent for delicate tasks, but highly inadvisable to chop a chicken bone in half. Which knife style will be the best fit for your task? There are plenty of knife styles and choices. Each of them serves a specific cuisine and cutting style better than the other. If you have any questions or need help choosing a knife style, leave them in the comment section below and I will try to help you as much as possible. If this video provided any value, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.